Hello everybody and welcome to this talk entitled A Modern GCMS Toolbox for Non-Target Screening. My name is Jürgen Wendt and I'm working as an application chemist in the European LIGO organization. Here, the outline of this presentation. I will start with one slide dealing with some company facts. Then I will introduce the concept of a modern GCMS toolbox for mainly non-target screening. It follows a presentation of the new multimode source. Then we come to a software topic. LIGO has introduced a new software tool called Chromatoff Tile for sample group comparison. Here I will give a brief introduction. After this, my talk will end with a short summary and conclusions. LIGO was founded in 1936 when a gentleman with the name Carl Schulz introduced the first rapid carbon determinator with steel industry. LIGO is an acronym of the original name Laboratory Equipment Corporation. Today, LIGO is an established global organization, still privately owned and actively run by the third generation. The headquarter in St. Joseph, Michigan is directly located on the Lake Michigan. Elemental analysis and mass spectrometry are the most important markets today. One of the main subsidiaries in Europe is the LIGO European Application and Technology Center in Berlin, located near by the old Tegel Airport. Before we come to the concept of the toolbox, I want to show you results of a non-targeted analysis trial organized by the EPA. This also to oppose the opinion that GCMS is not suitable for this analytical approach. As you can see, almost as many analytes are detected with GCMS as with LCMS. The next slide summarizes the components of a modern toolbox for non-target screening. It consists of comprehensive two-dimensional gas chromatography with increased separation capacity, high-resolution time-of-flight mass spectrometry with fast data acquisition, and full scan spectra, and finally different ionization techniques. Typical GC separation techniques are shown here. Still most used today is the GC separation using one column. For more complex samples and therefore higher demands on chromatographic separation, two-dimensional techniques are used. Firstly, and used for many years, the so-called hard cut chromatography. Here, a specific portion of the effluent from one column is diverted to a second column with different stationary phase during the run. Secondly, we have comprehensive 2D chromatography or GC times GC. Again, two different mechanisms of separation are used, but in contrast to hard cut, the complete effluent from the first column undergoes a further 2D separation. A modulator between the columns traps and releases sequential portions of the first column effluent and injects it to the second column. This results in a huge increase in chromatographic peak capacity and also increased sensitivity. An animation should show these processes. For an injected sample, we get 5 peaks using one-dimensional chromatography. By switching to GC times GC, by adding a modulator and a secondary column with a different stationary phase, we make usage of the increased separation power and can resolve 17 peaks. For GC operation, we have to modify the standard GC and add 2 additional components, a modulator and a separate oven for the second column, allowing for controlled temperature offsets to be applied. The functionality of the modulator has already been described. The trapping and releasing effects during modulation generates very small peaks in the second dimension and therefore results in increased sensitivity. Two types of GC-GC modulation are available for the LICO systems: thermal cryo, thermal consumable free, and flow modulation. Cryocooled thermal modulation uses liquid nitrogen cooled gas to trap the analytes via two jets. Hot air is used via two jets to inject the analyte bend into the second column. This is also called quadjet design. A consumable free version is also available. The principle is the same as with liquid nitrogen, except a chiller is used to cool the nitrogen gas. Therefore, the shape of the cold jet nozzles is slightly different to maximize trapping efficiency. The hot jet design is the same. Additionally, a flow modulation option is available. This is simpler to operate and also cheaper, as it requires no cryogens or chilling devices. But should be noted here that the performance characteristics of a flow modulated system is not that good compared to thermal modulation. All three modulators can be controlled completely via the Chromatov software. This wastewater analysis demonstrates the GC times GC separation power. It allows the separation of PCB 23 and 24 from a number of other components and interferences. So far, the chromatographic part of the toolbox. Let's come to the MS part. For this, LICO is using high-resolution time-of-flight mass spectrometry. Please allow me to start with some basics. Time of flight is probably the simplest method of mass measurements to conceptualize. The ion's mass to charge ratio is determined via a time measurement. The basic equation depicts that the flight time is proportional to a flight length and also proportional to the square root of a mass to charge ratio. The first TOF system, which was developed for routine analysis, was the Bendix TOF MS. However, the first version was only equipped with a direct inlet. Scientists at Dow Chemical then coupled the Bendix TOF MS to a homemade GC in the 50s of the last century. Talking about TOF characteristics, we have a non-scanning instrument that allows very high data acquisition rates. These are definitely needed in order to correctly record GC time GC peaks. A significant difference between TOF and scanning instruments is the spectral continuity of the TOF mass analyzer. Concentration changes during peak elution do not affect the TOF mass spectra. This is different to scanning mass spectrometer, such as a quadrupole. Here, changes in the analyte concentration results in skewed spectra. The current LICO TOF MS product folio consists of a benchtop system called Pegasus BT with normal mass resolution, which can be coupled to 1D or 2D GCs. In addition, LICO has a high resolution TOF MS, the Pegasus HRT, which we also can couple to both GC techniques. Regarding high-resolution TOF-MS, we have to consider that the resolution is proportional to a flight time. TOF instruments would require a flight tube of extreme length to approach resolving power of sectors or FTMS systems. LICO solves this problem by implementing the folded flight path technology. Two gridless mirrors and a set of periodic lenses build up the folded flight path structure. The ions enter the flight tube from the ion source and perform a defined number of reflections before they are collected by the detector. Two operating modes are determined by the number of reflections. 32 reflections lead to a total flight length of 20 meters, 64 reflections to a flight length of 40 meters, resulting in resolving power of 25,000, respectively 50,000. In the next section, I want to talk about the new multimode source, the design, operation and primary results. In the past, we had two IN sources for HRT operation, one for EI and one for CI positive. You had to switch sources if you want to run at different ionization mode, and this was not very convenient. Therefore, it would be great to have a universal source working equally well in EI, PCI, and NCI. The multimode source is fundamentally a two-chamber source, a high-pressure source on the left and a low-pressure source on the right, which are connected. You see one filament for CI in the high-pressure region and one filament for EI in the low-pressure region. The TC gas flow enters via the transfer line the high pressure source first. The next slide shows how the multimode source looks in reality. If you take it apart, you will get as individual parts the expansion electrode, the EI and CI source, and the repeller. In EI mode, the gas is flowing in the EI region. The ionization process takes place and the formed ions are sent to a mass analyzer. The characteristics of EI are known to you. Fragmentation is reproducible. Spectral libraries are commercially available, but there is often no molecular ion present. Therefore, chemical ionization is needed, especially for non-targeted screening. For CI operation, the BEV gas valve is opened and the CI filament is turned on. To describe the ionization processes in a simple way, there are a lot of ion molecule reactions in the source, resulting in a protonation and adduct formation in PCI and an electron attachment as main process in NCI. We can easily switch between the modes by usage of the Kramatorff acquisition queue. You see in this example that we are using the same sample vial, the same chromatographic method, but different MS method. Besides the easy transition between the modes, this setup allows us a peak alignment and makes usage of a different sensitivity and selectivity within the modes. Especially for environmental samples, negative CI is extremely sensitive. So far, I've only talked about hardware. In the last section of my talk, I want to give you some information about a new software tool called Kramatorff Tile. Let's start with an overview of the available data analysis tools for GC times GC data. The standard data processing software contains many functions for evaluating mainly individual samples. However, many users are interested in comparing sample sets, and this in a quick and easy way. Kramatorff Tile supplements the standard Kramatorff software and is intended to find differences between two or more groups of sample. It can be used for a broad range of application areas, including also environmental applications. Why is it called Kramatorff Tile? Tile is based on the work of Professor Sinovac. He created an algorithm which he called tile-based Fischer ratios. He co-partnered with him to develop it into a fully functional application. Essentially, the algorithm places a set of regions across each sample and also across the entire sample set to perform a comparison of the Fischer ratio across the classes. Here a visual example how Tile works. We have two sample groups. One sample set is Costa Rica coffee, the other French roast coffee. We have multiple samples on both. That's an important prerequisite. The next step is that we divide our 2D contour plot into tiles. Then we can calculate the Fischer ratio for each tile And for each mass, at the end, we get an output of tie locations and a list of masses with significant Fischer ratios. This approach leads to analytes which differ between the samples. The results are presented in a graphical interface. The F ratio hits pane. The analyzed data sets shown here contains 5 classes of different Belgian fruit style beer. On the left is the tile hits list with the corresponding F ratio hits. The heat on the table gives you immediate feedback on class distinction. It corresponds to a contour plot on the right. The example shown here indicates that there is a feature only in the banana beer and not in the other classes. Mass information for that particular tile is displayed at the bottom left, and autocorrelation sends the chosen tiles to the next step in data reviewing, which is the chemical features pane. You will find more information about tile on the LECO website. Let's come to a brief summary of the presentation. The ability to use a single source for EI, PCI, and NCI at their optimal conditions significantly simplifies reliable analytes assignment. In combination with GC times GC and high-resolution TOF-MS, the multimode source provides a powerful tool for non-target screening. Chromatophore Tile is a new data comparison tool to find differences between two or more groups of samples. It presents the information in an intuitive and highly graphical interface to allow users an easy and fast way to understand the differences. So thanks for participating and enjoy the rest of the conference, even if it's virtual this year.